Hi everyone, this is Billy. I have recently purchased some new variable capacitor made of copper and silver plated. So I thought of creating this new type of loop-based FM radio with this type of variable capacitor that I can find on the Chinese Taobao.com. This one is 40 RMB per piece, and then there is some other cheaper ones, 25 RMB per piece. RMB is the Chinese dollar. I think it's equivalent, one US dollar equivalent to around 6 RMB. So this is the one that I bought. It's 40 RMB. It looks to be silver plated, but I'm not too sure whether it's silver plated copper. It may be some chromium coated copper, something like that. So when I test the capacitance, it's between 25 and around 3 pf. I have some spare 3 millimeter copper wire, so I bend a coil, not too big, it's just around 3.5 inches in diameter. So that will fit nicely and match nicely with this variable capacitor. And you see there's four fixed plates and four moving plates when I start the project. But after I finish the project, I find the capacitance is still too much. So I use a clamp and took off one fixed plate and one copper plate. You can build this radio using either the MOSFET 3DQ. This is the diagram. It's the same as all other FM crystal radio I built, except that the coil, instead of multiple turns, we only have a single turn coil made of 3 millimeter copper wire, and the diameter of that C-shaped coil is 90 millimeter, or 3.5 inches. There's an opening of around 90 millimeter at one end. So if you connect the diode, you can try the different tapping point in the coil using the alligator clip. So one clip can connect to your diode, the other clip can connect to your antenna. You can try out different points of the coil to see which one gives you the best performance of sensitivity and selectivity. Most importantly, how clear are the FM signal. For the antenna, you can use the 1.2 meters extensible telescopic radio antenna, or if you have a Yagi antenna at home, you can hook up one point of your Yagi antenna to this coil. Next, let me show you the finished product before the testing. Okay, I've mounted the circuit to a board. This is just a base I've printed using the 3D printer plus the Arglic board, so we can see through it. So we have the 3DQ. It's a MOSFET. The G1 gate is connected. This is the G1 gate. G1 gate is connected to the moving plate of the variable cap, which is the ground also for the circuit. And then the G2 gate here from the MOSFET is connected to the hot end of the coil, which is also the fixed plate of the variable cap. And then we have the source pole of the MOSFET. This is the source pole of the MOSFET clipped to 1/4 of the turn of this one turn coil. This one turn coil is about 3.5 inches diameter. And then the drain D pole of the MOSFET is connected to this
audio jack that we use to connect to a headphone. And this audio jack, the other end of that connect to the grounding point of the circuit. And there's a capacitor for high frequency bypass. It's around 200 pf. You can choose anything from 80 pf to 200 pf. So let's test it, and we will be able to test what if we clip this source pole to the middle of the coil or to here, and see what's the difference in terms of sensitivity and selectivity. For the antenna, we can also clip into any part of this coil, so you get the best impedance matching.
Here is the testing. I hook it up to my Yagi antenna, and let's see how it performs.